Oh yeah, time to ring the bell. Time for victory.
What's up?
Time for victory.
So we turn the Mayan calendar stone, and that rings the giant European bell, which brings us to the Ottoman Hagia Sophia.
This place is just a hodgepodge, isn't it?
Dark Souls has always been a hodgepodge. It's a beautiful hodgepodge. I love the deck.
Oh, hey, is that a Lothric down there?
Might be. I wonder what this place, because this place doesn't remind me of any place that actually exists in Dark Souls 1. Unless this is a play on the Dragon Sanctuary.
Yeah, it could be.
I mean, I feel like a lot of these areas are Miyazaki's reimaginings of Dark Souls 2 areas, which, in my opinion, are better than the originals in Dark Souls 2. Like, this is a way better Dragon Sanctuary. It's gorgeous. A ton of fun.
I've already forgotten what Dragon Sanctuary looked like.
Because it was filled with awful dragon knights. Not the ones dressed as dragons, just the regular knights. Especially the ones with the maces that could do infinite hammer.
Oh, this was the first DLC, right?
No.
No?
No, it was in the main game. It's where you meet the dragon who gives you the mist that lets you travel back.
Yeah, with the ancient dragon at the top.
Where you can summon.
Okay, I'll try not to die now knowing that I only have a couple Estus charges than what I had before. Don't worry, I don't think he can either. Fire, quick. No, get fire.
Kind of weirdly corrected to my location. Did that downward fire attack.
You know, this guy reminds me a lot of Argorok with his movements. And you don't even know who Argorok is, so I probably shouldn't even mention it.
He's
a boss from, Twilight Princess, who is also a dragon.
Okay. Are you serious? Now I can hate you. Now, this is a very different boss than I'm used to in a Dark Souls game.
Yeah.
What with, there's a xylophone part in this that reminds me of a different, there's a different game that I seem to remember a boss fight having a similar sound. I just don't know what that is.
Couldn't tell ya. Okay, so, he's ready for, I guess he just died.
I need to watch this again.
Posterity?
No, it's awesome. I've only seen it once. This is like, sorry, you're leaving me. And then he creates a fucking tornado. I came from Bloodborne for this?
Yeah, I guess this is in my job description.
It's like fighting Martyr Lagarius, but thousands of times worse. Actually, now that I think about it, this has a lot of similarities to Lagarius. Holy shit!
Does this really have that many similarities?
But in presentation, most definitely. All the fogginess and stuff, and the ways in which he attacks.
Didn't Lagarius, like, have skulls and things that he used?
Floating. No, I'm not saying exact, but there's a lot of thematic similarities to the way he attacks, moves.
I found
him. I mean, Hickory has borrowed plenty from Ornstein, that much is for sure. It's not readily apparent if you're looking at this on the surface, but,
I'll get him! There's no way he can survive! He killed me.
Does it involve this place?
Okay,
I don't know, I looked at like four words.
Alright, well, for those of you joining us now, we were just in an argument about how the hell to get the third ending of this game, because we both got...
It wasn't an argument! It was you asking how you do it, and I'm like, I don't know.
Well, I know, but it just, like... Did I say argument?
You did say argument!
Oh, okay, my apologies. The discussion about the third ending of this game. I know nothing about it, and honestly, I would like to get it on camera.
Tell you what, when I New Game Plus this, I might just do a solo run, because I gotta go trophy hunting and all that.
New Game Plus? I'm not New Game Plus in this game.
Really?
No. Unless you come back to me and tell me there's actually things different, I don't trust a Miyazaki-made Souls game to have anything different than New Game Plus. I really don't.
Well, I'll tell you whether or not it gets different.
Yeah, if anything different happens, let me know, but I'm totally joining you for a New Game Plus.
You know, this guy is so cool, he's not even on his drag while he's doing anything. Like, if you look closely at him, he's just hovering a little bit above his dragon. It's beautiful.
Hey, man, collision's hard. What if two bottles flush with each other when they're not, when they have, like, God knows how many polygons? Might
flip.
Like, oh man,
take
a float. They won't notice. Oh, he's standing on
even
the dragon. That's
radical. Only when the dragon's flying. And he's doing the thunderbolt.
So I didn't get hit.
I got hit several times.
I wish this didn't take quite as long, because I love the lightning tornado. So cool. Like, I still can't decide what my favorite my favorite basic element is from Final Fantasy, the Japanese RPG nonsense of whether I like lightning or fire. I always split between the two, because fire in these games is always gorgeous. Whatever they've done, they've made fire look magnificent. Lightning looks great, but fire is just so fucking good because the lighting in this game is so amazing.
Question, does wind count as its own element?
What?
Does wind count as its own element?
Well, in this case, I think they're implying that lightning and wind are tied together.
Okay. Because I typically roll with wind, because I think wind is pretty cool.
Oh. I only like wind when it's tied with lightning. I'm good.
I see that.
Because otherwise I'd find wind to be really boring. Like, you know, like, I could punch wind at you. It's like, so what? I could punch fire at you.
Yeah, but you see, the guy punching wind at you can blow the fire back in your face.
Yeah, but he's also feeding the flames, so it's a...
Into your face!
Anyway, I find wind less impressive, because you can create what are essentially... Because shockwaves are... You can consider shockwaves a form of a wind attack, and you can create those with explosives, because it's about pressure.
I don't know, wind has always just looked really cool to me.
Fire and lightning are much more insane. Lightning being the... Fire being the most preposterous, lightning being the craziest. Because lightning means what you're doing is you have an extreme electric charge one way or the other. Either you're giving up electrons or you're receiving them. Either way, you're doing some awesome shit. And the weird part is if you actually attacked with lightning the way lightning works, you would actually, the attack of your lightning attack would literally be the moving of electrons from your bow to yourself, which would mean that you have an extremely positive charge, which means that what you would see is the lightning coming from the enemy to, like, your fist. Because I would say it's probably much more damaging to, it's debatable. Moving electrons either way would be damaging, but whether you want to move electrons to them or from them is, like, just the idea of even being able to freely mess with your electric charge is kind of cool.
But, I mean, you can do that just by shuffling your feet. It's not that impressive.
Well, yeah, because what you do is you're rubbing off excess, I don't remember if it's you're rubbing off your electrons or you're rubbing and gaining electrons. I don't remember which, but, I'm talking, like, at will being able to move, polarize your body so that one end is extremely positive, one end is extremely negative. Or, better yet, just being able to move a huge amount of electrons off your body. Or, like, I don't know, it's very confusing. I think it's actually physically impossible to manipulate lightning as a human being, anyway. Well, there are biological functions that jog people. There are electric eels. So, I don't know. It's a curious thing.
Why does this guy take damage when he comes in?
He didn't.
No, well, there's a big old number of 4,000 popped up on my screen saying that
that's
he
took total health.
That's his total health?
Yeah, that's showing that number is actually the total health being brought up.
Oh.
And that happens. Oh, shit.
Is that what that is? That's
yeah.
Weird.
It's a weird little bug.
Hey, could you do me a favor and not die? That'd be cool.
Got it?
No, that can't be the max health. That can't be his health.
Oh, shit. No! Yeah.
Because one time we came in and he had... Aw, damn it. One time we came in and he only had 2,000. Well, that went surprisingly well, actually.
Oh, okay. Please don't say things. No. Oh, buddy.
My buddy missed. You poked me. Please stop. Buddy, please. Aw, oh, looks like somebody's angry.
Wait. Fuck my... Eh? Where is he gonna... Oh, right.
Yeah, it's,
That was a waste. Shit.
Right, that one's got a secondary attack. Or secondary hit. What the hell, man? What did I do to you? That's not a reason to try and kill somebody. A big jerk! A big smelly jerk!
Oh boy! Oh, he's a nameless kid.
You smelly jerk! Get down here! Where'd you go? I hate you so much! Eat my hammer! Whack-a-mole! That was easy.
Oh, Oh, yeah, I figured out you can get that emote as early as, the Abyss Watchers.
Which emote was that? I wasn't paying attention.
The sword, by my sword.
Is that the one where you raised it and you taunt me? Like, hey, look at me, I got this, and you don't.
No, it's... I do it because I love it. Great. It's an excellent way to greet anyone. But, you can get that as early as the Abyss Watchers, because you can bring in Blackhand, Goddard, and that's how you get it.
Wow, so I missed it twice.
Yeah. Totally worth it, though.
Ah, well, I can get in my second playthrough. Because I know there's going to be three playthroughs of this game. For those of you who don't know me, I have to get that platinum. I'm going on ahead.
Look at the trophies for the XCOM games, and they're completely nuts.
I'm going to make it. I didn't make it.
Night Night's Lab.
Wait, what?
Night Night's Lab.
Cool. That's number five, right?
Yeah. Who's handing them out?
Yeah, except there's no enemy that just hands them out.
Yeah, that is troublesome. I would hope that there actually is, but, I don't know.
Any idea if we can summon each other in or not? Back here, at least? I guess there's probably no bosses left, because...
Sick!
No, we can't summon each other in.
I just picked up. You know what awesome thing I just found.
I don't, but I will find it eventually.
Hang on.
Is it a ring?
Better.
If it's an armor set, I'm gonna be kind of upset.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't think there's a trophy associated with that, so it's not really my, priorities.
Hey man, what I consider important and what you consider important are obviously different, but I'm extremely happy with what I picked up.
That's totally a breakable wall if I ever seen one. Where did you pick it up at? Oh.
It's behind one of the pillars of one of the staircases, like the last.
Is it the Dragon Slayer set?
Yes. Ornstein's equipment that I've been bitching about, even though I want the redesign.
Well, this explains why you couldn't buy it.
Well, yeah, but the problem I have with it is that it's the exact same, and I kind of wanted, and it searched for the nameless king.
Oh.
What?
Oh, I'm so... No! No!
What? No, oh, that doesn't make any sense.
Are you serious, game? Do you know where this leads you?
Hang on.
Hey, cool, an elevator. Where this goes. Oh. Hey. I don't know where this is. Yeah, I deserve that. Have you found out where it goes yet?
Not yet.
You haven't realized it?
Worked on it.
You've gone all the way down the, what was that, a bridge?
Yeah. Hang on. Oh. Oh. The stupid fucking game.
We did all of that for a shortcut.
So
we don't have to do any more of the stuff.
problem I'm having with this, though, is that...
There was no reason for it?
No, just... Hang on a minute. I need to beat the shit out of this dragon, Drake Blood Knight. Bitch, you're gonna drop me something sooner or later. The problem I have with the fact that what this... problem I have with what this says is that the fight with Ornstein and Smough didn't happen. Because canonically, in the fight with Ornstein and Smough, one of them dies. I mean, technically both of them die. But at the very least, one of them gets absorbed by the other. So what does this, like, the implications of Ornstein leaving to come here? Was it an illusion that you fought Ornstein's blood? That doesn't make any fucking sense. I'm pretty sure you can break the illusion of Banner Londo before you fight them. Okay. I'm gonna pray. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. But I'm pretty sure... Can we get that ring? Yeah, I'm pretty sure you can get the ring that opens up that door before you even get the word of that stuff. I don't know. Very strange. But, no, it's like...
The dragon go.
It's just, it's slightly upsetting that, it would be... Oh, I missed it. It's just an item.
What's that dragon? Kill all the dogs and he just leaves? What? Dragon, you suck! We're gonna have this big old fight and you're just like, nope, I'm out. See you later, guys. By the way, go talk to the blacksmith. When you get a chance.
Wait, what item did you pick up that you said was the item? Like, where did you get that?
The grass?
Yeah.
The blacksmith.
From the blacksmith?
Yeah, he's just like, yo, here you go. Here you go, bro.
Must be part of the special ending. That's my guess.
Wow, that guy does not take damage very well. Then again, he is naked, so...
Oh my god.
Alright, well, I'm gonna head over to, the Farron Mausoleum.
What?
The Farron Mausoleum. I'm gonna head over there.
Okay.
Any idea where that is?
No.
Good, because I have no idea. That's just where the item tells me to go.
Farron Mausoleum. Go to the old Wolf of Farron.
That's what my plan was. Yo, Wolfie. No, you don't get that. Come to the Mausoleum in Farum. Only one can take the path of the ancient dragons. This entire area is for Farron, right?
I don't know.
You're not very helpful.
I know. You're asking me questions.
You're the Dark Souls Master.
Hey, Farron, I am not the Dark Souls Master.
You've beat like four of them.
Wait, what?
You've beat like four Dark Souls games.
I beat Dark Souls 1. Dark Souls 2, and now Dark Souls 3.
And Bloodborne. Yeah, well, no, and Bloodborne is just Dark Souls, but with blood.
Never beat Bloodborne.
Well, you beat Garamond, so I mean, that's close enough.
Beat Garamond with help. I helped beat Garamond. I never beat Garamond on any of my files.
You beat Maria, and Maria's pretty much just Garamond.
Oh, she's easier than Garamond. I know that much.
Because she is Fire Garamond.
Alright, you are not the Mausoleum, so if there's a Mausoleum, I have an idea of where to start.
You got an idea where to start? That's more than I do. That's more than what I got.
The Abyss Watcher's boss room?
That was sort of my guess. Yo, Dark Reds, what's up? Sorry! I'm so much stronger than you! Ain't nothing you can do about me!
I was so hoping to meet the Serpents.
Hey, cool, Dark Sword.
I really want to do a Dark Souls 1 playthrough.
In due time.
Get to meet the awesome Serpents. It's not necessarily a... Oh!
I got poison. So did something happen, or... Ah, oh, hey, cool. Yo, what's up, Oh, no, what the fuck? This isn't fair, I'm poisoned!
Oh, boy.
What the hell is this chump? Oh! Is he the sad chump? The sad chump from the sanctuary? Or the shrine?
Yeah, and apparently he's a dragon man.
What the hell, sad chump? Why you gotta hit me?
Hey!
Sad chump, if I weren't poisoned right now, I'd probably be able to not, well, hey, you don't get to heal.
This fight is kind of rad, actually, because we've been, you know that point in Fire Emblem Awakening where Marth, quote-unquote, and, what's this, Krong clash, like, swords pointing forward? I had that exact moment where we both did thrust attacks straight at each other. It was awesome.
The best thing I've gotten to do with him is we healed at the same time.
Nice.
He's making me look like a chump here.
Oh, I fucked him up. Alright.
I got him. I got him while I was poisoned.
Stones. I have twinkling dragon stones.
So, is that it now? Is that all of the bosses, all of the game? I think that might be all of the bosses, all of the game.
I think so. Hang on, I gotta transform into a dragon.
Wait, what?
Dragon headstones that I can't use because I killed the... Shit!
Where do I find those at? Where do I find the headstones? What part of my inventory has that?
It's in your consumables.
Ah.
They don't work anymore because we killed the fucking king.
That's so good! That's so awesome! King Dragon Torso and roar until death.
Yeah. With the sparkling one, you get to breathe next to an apparition of a goddamn dragon. Dead in my life. I'll have to do that on a different fucking profile.
No, you just gotta do it in New Game Plus.
Oh, shut up.
Okay,
but
well...
you don't take most of those items in New Game Plus anyway, so...
Well, you'd have to for this one, at least, because, I mean, you can't get this one until the king is dead.
Incorrect.
Really?
I'm willing to bet just discovering that place is what triggers all of that.
Nah, it could be.
Or, at the very least, getting the sparkling torso is probably what does it. Like, at the most.
Alright, well, thank you to everybody who's watched us up until this point.
Dumb. At some point, we'll put up the third ending, and maybe the first ending, I don't know.
Well, I'll probably record both of them, so we can talk over them, or something, I don't know.
It'd work. At this point, only you can be the one to get those endings so we can record it. I need to fix that at some point. But, yeah, we stupided our way through Dark Souls 3. We put out the fire. It's still pretty goddamn bright out here, but whatever.
Oh, no, it's fine.
But, we fought some radical bosses. Currently, my favorite is still the final boss, because he's Dark Souls players, which is awesome. And he has the fire effect, which of course everyone who's watched this, and if they ever get to watch me play Bloodborne, will realize I basically jack off over the kind of fire effect. It gets me going. Like, really nothing else to say about it. It's just, it's the best. It's the fire in this engine. So goddamn gorgeous. So you can be certain you'll be seeing playthroughs of other Souls games. In what capacity we'll be doing them, I don't know. I have an idea of who I want to bring along, at least on Bloodborne, for another romp. That trio made for a most excellent commentary. You'll be seeing, I guarantee you, you'll be seeing Dark Souls and Demon Souls.
Yeah,
because
I forgot to play those.
Dark Souls 2, we'll debate it. It's kind of... I have a lot to say about Dark Souls 2. And, I don't know. I don't know if it's even worth... Like, it's basically me on a broken record talking about how Dark Souls 2 is really good, but not as good as... Dark Souls 1, even though there are ways in which Dark Souls 2 exceeds Dark Souls 1. Nobody wants to hear that, because you basically got a whiff of it with me talking about Dark Souls 3. So, me playing through Dark Souls 2 is probably not what anyone wants to watch. Especially since, honestly, I don't like, now that I've played Dark Souls 3, I don't think I'm ever going to want to play Dark Souls 2.
I think I burned myself out of it when I played it last time, so... Because I think I ended up with, like, 4 runs through it in, like, a month.
Yeah, it's tiresome. It's tedious. It's very strange how Dark Souls 2, to me, is a bit more... I don't know. It feels more like a job than the other Souls games.
Hey, at least it wasn't so linear.
Well, it's not. That's the thing. Dark Souls 3 is more linear than Dark Souls 2.
Dark Souls 3 is really linear. Aside from that one time we took the branching path and went the wrong way, and it was beautiful.
Yeah, and then screwed up the entire quest with, What's-Her-Face.
That was some good stuff right there.
I'm fucking pissed. I wanted her armor at the very least.
By the way, you can't see this, but I've been toasting for, like, the last 5 minutes.
You've been what?
I've been toasting.
Nice. But yeah, as far as content, like, yes, other Souls games will happen. No, they're not happening right away. This is not going to be a Souls channel. It never will be. We love more games than Souls. In fact, our first and foremost love, I mean, if I can speak for both of us, is probably Pokemon.
Yeah, I'd say so. Pokemon's definitely in my top three of games, game franchises.
I would say for me, it's probably, it's the most important. It's the one that it's the one that still has the most of my love. Like, out of everything else, like, I still love the Persona series. We're not gonna do a goddamn Persona playthrough on this. Like, I have nothing to add on Persona. I'm not like German Spy where I can talk about Japan. I can just love all over Persona. And that's about it. So, that's probably never going to happen unless Persona 5 is, like, somehow worthwhile. But
that is, like, what, an 80-hour game?
Yeah, I don't want to do an 80-hour playthrough. That's just not going to be fun.
Like, this is 40 hours, maybe, and we're already at, like, we're at part 77.
Yeah.
Granted, we finished up on part 67.
Well, here's the thing, guys. We will be back for the DLC. There is at least two different DLCs guaranteed for this game. We'll be there. Or we'll be here, wherever you want to put it. We will be here, we will be coming back as... Actually, if that's the case, it may be worth your time to do a different playthrough for your trophy hunting. That way we can use these characters at endgame to do the DLC.
Wouldn't it not really... I guess it would matter, because I'd be on New Game Plus 2 or something like that.
Yeah. So,
don't worry, I'll back up this file on a hard drive or on a USB stick, and then I'll just... No, that wouldn't work. Unless I get a platinum, then it would work.
I don't know. But yeah, expect, I guess people, expect weird stuff from here on out. Although, I would hope, by the time this episode comes up, there'll be other things going on, so this entire explanation will be pointless.
Oh no, these are all going up, single file. I don't know, yeah, probably. We'll have other stuff up there.
Yeah, I mean, we'll want some variety, of course, and hopefully you'll have the variety, and this entire monologue of me talking about future ideas will be totally pointless and already done. But anyway, thanks a bunch. I had a blast.
I hated this game. It was the worst one. Taking it back.
Shut up. I'll invade you and kill you, goddammit. This game was amazing.
You can't invade Popovo. Popovo is invadable.
Well, since you kill all the bosses, I think that actually is true.
Popovo's legacy will stand for all time.
Been really fun. I'm having an interesting time adapting to my what is for me a new persona. Geltzer was a name I made up because I wanted a name that didn't have numbers and an MMO. So
great, now we're getting the explanation for our names.
77
parts in! You finally know who we are.
Well, I mean, it's whatever. It's an odd one that I guess it adopting it's going to be weird for me, but I'll get used to it.
You see, I just got my name from a friend who we were messing around at work, and yeah, he gave me a nickname, and I'm just like, that's it. That's what I'm going with.
I was given a nickname that I think technically was a women's form of my name, but I ended up adopting and, respelling for my own amusement. I really liked it. I quote-unquote Latinized my name. That name probably won't be making many public appearances because of... In case I'm actually worried. Like, once the internet figures out who I really am, then I guess I won't give a shit. But until then, I'll be Gelpser. I don't mind. It's a decent name. Bunch of letters I put together so I could have a RuneScape account with no numbers on it. I hope people are watching.
Oh no, they turned it off like 5 minutes ago.
Yeah.
We can say whatever we want here.
But I hope people enjoyed watching, I hope people actually are watching, and I hope more people will continue to watch as we play through other games. Other games that I like, other games that Frontier likes.
By the way, I've got a crazy amount of games I want to show you.
Games that none of us like, you know.
I've got a bunch of those!
Torture ourselves for a few of these. I have awful, awful plans of playing through some of the shooters I most dislike. The one that we have planned, I don't want to do it. It's a game I've beaten, and I don't want to beat
it. I can't wait for it. This sounds great.
Anyway, so I guess see y'all later.
Alright. That's a good enough ending for me.